So we've pretty well completed our exterior envelope insulation. So we've done the walls, we've done the backside of our roof deck. Of course, in the previous episode, we did the exterior walls. But now it's time to move to the inside of the house. There's a product known as Safensound that ROCKWOOL offers to offer some sound benefit between private spaces and common spaces in the house. And that's what we're gonna do next right here at the laundry room, right, Joe?
And this is a great example of it. So we're gonna use the Safensound in the laundry room, which is right next to the living room. So the homeowner doesn't wanna be entertaining or just sitting by their fireplace and hearing their washer and dryer going. So we're gonna put it in there. There's some fire benefits to that. We'll also use it in the bathroom. In a case of a two-story house, we'd use it between floors just to isolate the sound.
Yeah, one of the things that we've talked about just a little bit in this is the reduction of flame spread. So anytime you place a ROCKWOOL product in your wall, you're reducing the ability of fire to spread through that cavity. Of course, wood is still flammable. It still has the potential to burn. So with your drywall installed, half-inch drywall, you're gonna get a 20-minute fire rating. If we were doing 5/8, it'd be a full one-hour rating on that wall. But the ability of the flame to spread throughout the wall cavity is what we're reducing with the Safensound product. So in a case like this, where we have our laundry room right off the living room, where Joe's talking about, you get the comfort benefit of the privacy, not listening to the spin cycle ramp up on your washer while you're trying to watch your favorite movie. You also have the peace of mind that if you're not up on your maintenance and you're not cleaning out your dryer vent and you do get a lint fire, you have a reduced ability for that flame to spread through your wall, and you're basically reducing your risk of damage to your house. Yeah, it's a tremendous value add. There's really not much to the install any different than a wall cavity, other than obviously you can push it all the way through on a partition wall. You're really maximizing the benefit of that dense product in this application. Place it and it stays.
Yeah.
So the product that you're seeing here is the compressed for shipping Safensound product. It's going to expand back to its original 3-inch thickness. And I know it looks a little bit different than the comfort mat that we were putting in the walls, because that's a 5.5-inch thick product. And the reason it is only 3 inches rather than 3.5 is that it doesn't transmit the sound as well through by not having the full contact on both sides of the wall. This is a product that they've been using in music studios for years to reduce sound transmission. It's pretty time tested, very effective.
Yeah, so the installation process is pretty much the same with all the ROCKWOOL materials. So right here, I'm just gonna make a nice little slice in the ROCKWOOL, and I'm just gonna tuck it right on top of the wire, right below the wire, and just work it down between the studs. And then we're not getting any, it's not gonna project into the room, and we won't have any humps in your drywall. One of the benefits about using the Safensound on an interior wall where there is water located in that wall, right here we have a sink faucet, water lines, and drain. And so if there ever was a leak inside your wall, you wouldn't have to rip the entire wall out to get your water remediation completed. The ROCKWOOL is free draining. It doesn't support mold growth. And so we'll say a scenario where you do have a leak in your drain. You're going to see that water come down through the drywall. You're really only cutting the drywall a few inches, putting a fan in there to dry it. Obviously, you have to fix your leak, but you don't have to worry about the ROCKWOOL sitting in the wall, creating mold, touching the wood, spreading the mold. It's isolated. It's just going to dry out, and then it's still going to perform the exact same way.
Because the bracket and stub outs for the future sink are on my side, I'm gonna have to split this off at 38 inches because there's just too much to work around here. But I should be able to tuck this in to the vent pipe and hold that up. Joe, are you able to split that for the wire?
Yeah, I can help you with that.
I'll give you a little resistance right at the wire. One of the nice things about working partition walls is you've got access to both sides, so you can just kind of help each other out.
And around down here, we have our penetration through the bottom plate. We'll go ahead and just stuff ROCKWOOL back there.
It's a nice thing to be able to offer peace of mind to your client with the hydrophobic characteristics of the product, not having to think about replacing an entire wall section due to a plumbing leak is a pretty nice benefit. I think you're right, Joe. I think we're just gonna have to stuff in around. There's a lot of plumbing in that section.
Oh, it looks great.
And by having the insulation on the opposite side, we've allowed it to block the sound transmission as much as we can. If we had done a 2x6 wall cavity in this location, we could have really filled up on both sides of the pipe, and that would have allowed for even more sound reduction.
So one of the benefits of using the Safensound versus the Comfort Bat for soundproofing is you can see we have ladder blocking going all up this wall. And with this thinner product, I can just put it right in. I don't have to cut around all the 2x4s, which really improves the overall speed of the insulation.